Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I wanted to share an updo that I think would be so perfect for a holiday party, New Year's Eve, or what have you, but of course you could also wear this for any special occasion or just for fun. Comment down below what you think about this look. Make sure to like and subscribe if you're new to my channel. Click that bell as always, then you'll never miss any future videos. And let's get started. To begin this hairstyle, I'm going to combine all of my hair into a low ponytail at the nape of my neck. I'm not going to part my hair, though you could part it if you wanted to, but instead I'm just going to bring it down and back over my ears. To smooth out the crown area, I'm going to comb through it and use some hairspray to smooth down any bumps or loose flyaway hairs. Now, using a hairband, I'm going to tie off the hair at the nape of my neck. Then once the hair is tied off, I'm going to divide the ponytail into two equal sections. I'm going to be braiding both of these sections into a regular three-strand braid. Starting with one section of the ponytail, I'm going to divide it into three smaller sections. And since I'm doing a braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands under the middle strand. You can cross them over the middle or under the middle. I just decided to do under because it was a little bit easier. So I'm going to cross the left strand under the middle, then cross the right strand under the middle, and I'm going to alternate between crossing the two side strands under the middle strand, and I'm going to work my way down to the ends of the section. So I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand, alternating between the left side under the middle, then crossing the right strand under the middle until the braid reaches the bottom of the hair. And you want to try and braid all the way to the ends without leaving a big section of hair unbraided at the bottom. This will just make pinning the braid a little bit easier to do. When the braid reaches the ends, I'm going to take a clear elastic band and tie off the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to repeat the same process with the other section of the ponytail. I'm dividing this section of hair into three smaller sections, and I'm going to cross the side strands under the middle strand again. So I'm crossing the left strand under the middle, then crossing the right strand under the middle. And I'm going to work my way down to the ends of the hair, crossing the side strands under the middle strand. So I'm just alternating between crossing the left and the right side strands under the middle strand. So crossing the left strand under the middle, then crossing the right strand under the middle, then crossing the left strand under the middle again, and working my way down until the braid reaches the bottom of the hair. Then when the braid reaches the ends, I'm going to tie off the end of the braid with a clear elastic band so that it doesn't unravel. And now that these two sections of the ponytail are braided, I'm going to use them to create the bun. First, I'm going to take some hair padding and place this above the ponytail. This will help anchor the braids in place so they have something to pin into. It will also help create a bigger looking bun. The important thing is that your braids need to cover and hide the padding, so keep that in mind when you're doing this hairstyle. So I'm just using bobby pins to pin the padding in place, and I'm gripping a bit of the hair padding and then sliding the pins into the hair towards the center. And I used about two pins for each side of the padding, the right side and the left side. Now I'm going to use the two braids to create the low bun. I'm picking up the left braid first, and I'm going to bring it up over the hair padding towards the top of the ponytail. At the top of the bun, I'm going to pin the braid in place using some bobby pins. And now I'm going to take the right braid and drape this over the padding next to the first braid on the right side. So remember, the goal is to hide the hair padding with the braids. So if you need to pull the sides of the braids out a little bit, you can, to make the braids a little bit wider. So I'm pinning the braid at the top of the hair padding, sliding them in towards the center of the bun. So now with the ends of the braids, I'm going to use these to hide any padding that is still showing on the edges. I did pull on the sides of my braid to widen it a little bit since the end of the braid is a little bit skinnier, usually near the bottom. I needed to make sure it was going to cover up the hair padding well enough. And you can use a smaller section of padding if you need to hide it more easily. So I'm laying the braid going down the right side of the bun around the other braid, and then I'm going to pin it underneath with some more bobby pins. And then I'm going to repeat the same thing on the left side of the bun. So I'm taking the end of the other braid and I'm going to wrap it around the left side of the bun and tuck the end underneath the bun at the bottom near the nape of my neck. Then I'm going to pin it in place, sliding bobby pins into the hair upwards towards the center of the bun so they're hidden. You can use as many bobby pins as you need to. I used about 3 bobby pins to pin this last braid in place, just to make sure it felt nice and secured in place and wasn't going to fall loose. Then once the braid is all pinned up, I went back over the crown to detail it a little bit. So I pinched and pulled on small pieces of hair around the crown and loosened them out of the bun so it would create some volume and texture in the style. But then, of course, I'm just going to set the style with a firm hold hairspray and smooth down any loose flyaway hairs.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, make sure to click the thumbs up. If you didn't, click the thumbs down. Either way, it helps me out. If you haven't subscribed to my channel and you're new, be sure to subscribe and click that notification bell. Then you'll be notified every time I post a new tutorial. And I will see you next time.